Good morning. Would you please rise for the processional?
Thank you all. You may be seated. Well, good morning, everyone. My name is Dr. Mark Okamoto. I am Dean and Professor at the CHSU College of Pharmacy, and it's my distinct pleasure to welcome you to this commencement ceremony. We ask at this time that you silence all of your electronic devices. You are welcome to take photos while remaining seated during the ceremony. We have professional photography and video being recorded today that will be available to you in the future. The ceremony is also being live streamed through the CHSU Facebook page. Now I invite Ms. Nancy Jeong and Dr. Brandon Singh Aulak to the stage. Please stand for the national anthem, which will be immediately followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.
Oh, say can you see? Broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red.
Standing for Pledge of Allegiance. The flag is right here on the right side of the stage. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Ms. Jeong and Dr. Aulak. You may all be seated. It's now with great pleasure that I introduce to you Florence Dunn, founding president for California Health Sciences University.
Good morning. It's my honor to welcome our trustees, administration, faculty, staff, and especially all the guests and all the family friends to celebrate our California Health Sciences University College of Pharmacy Class of 2022. These last couple of years presented our university and especially our students with unprecedented challenges. I'm proud to say our graduates' strength and resilience have guided them to become the professionals you see today. Of course, our graduates didn't do it alone. I'm delighted to see so many family, friends here today who I'm certain have made sacrifices to ensure the graduates succeeded. Graduates, can you please stand? Face your audience. And now please give them the round of applause they deserve. Thank you. Please be seated. While you may not have seen every day, our founders and our board of trustees have been supporting you every step of the way. The leadership and commitment to improve the healthcare outcomes of our valley is what inspire all of us at CHSU to put our mission into action. I'm also grateful for our administration, faculty, staff, and it's my privilege to share this day of celebration with all of you. And now to our College of Pharmacy Class of 2022. You began your journey here with dreams of becoming a pharmacist. You arrived with determination, and you are proof that possibilities are endless when you believe in yourself. Today, you will embark on a new professional career, dedicating your lives to helping patients. We are counting on you to help transform healthcare in our region. Today, we celebrate you, part of our legacy, and we are proud of the professionals you have become. We hope that you will continue to believe in CHSU and stay connected as alumni. Although gaining knowledge in your profession is essential, just remember, it is ethics and kindness that form your soul. I want to leave you with this one request. During your life's journey, leading up to accomplishing this milestone today, many doors were opened for you. Now that you have crossed this threshold, please turn around, open the door, extend your hand, and let the next person through. It has been my privilege and honor to serve as your president, and I'm looking forward to watching all of you soar. Thank you.
Thank you, President Dunn, Chairman Ikeda, Trustees, Provost Kim, President Dunn, Dean Granito, the administrators, faculty, staff, families and friends, and of course, our Doctor of Pharmacy graduates for the College of Pharmacy for 2022. I welcome this class of 2022 to service for the common good, to lead in challenging times, to further biomedical knowledge and prevent disease and suffering, and to cure when possible. But most of all, to comfort those who are ill, to maintain or improve on all patients' quality of life. You have spent the last 4 years becoming prepared for this lifelong journey you have chosen. There will be many challenges on this journey. Challenges in industry, in government, with healthcare systems, science, and technology. The world is a complex and unpredictable place, but you have been well trained to be able to provide treatment to the patients for whom you serve, as those before you have done so well. I am confident that you will meet these challenges and further the profession of pharmacy. Now I would like to recognize our graduates who earned the following academic honors. Wearing a red honor cord, the graduates who earned the academic honor of cum laude, which means with distinction, with a grade point average of 3.5 to 3.69. For those graduates who earned the red honor cord, please stand. Wearing the silver honor cord were the graduates who earned the academic honor of magna cum laude, which means with great distinction, with a grade point average of 3.70 to 3.89. Please stand. And wearing the gold honor cord with the graduates who earned the academic honor of summa cum laude, which means with the highest distinction, with a grade point average of 3.90 to 4.0, please stand. Please give our graduates who earn all of these academic honors a round of applause for achieving this. And as a side note, I will tell you, I taught some of the classes for these students, and those who were standing before you, they earned every bit of it. We are now excited to begin the doctoral hooding ceremony, which is a tradition afforded to those that earn a doctoral degree. Dr. Anita Shenoy, Dr. Stanley Snowden, and I are honored to participate in this hooding ceremony.
Candidates, as your name is called, please come forward to receive your hood and diploma. Dr. Rafael O. Alkasi. Dr. Romaldo K. Aquino. Dr. Stephanie Martinez Aquino. Dr. Brandon Singh Olak. Dr. Nicholas A. Austin. Dr. Irina Boginski. Dr. Simranpreet Brar. Dr. Alexa Crown. Woo! Dr. Julie T. Dow. Dr. Carlos Augusto Escobar. Dr. Naveed Fani. Dr. Arshpreet Gill. Dr. Imrandeep Gill. Dr. Patricia Gonzalez Medina. Dr. Yvette Hernandez. Dr. Kanwar Inderjeet Singh Hundal. Dr. Minal Saif Hussain. Dr. Rebecca Ann Jimenez. Dr. Abigail Joy. Dr. Sharandeep Kaur. Dr. Dr. Simarpreet Kaur. Dr. Maroj Michael Karazian. Dr. Laura Karayan. Dr. Patricia May Zabala Luna. Dr. Trenton Michael Lutz. Dr. Alexis Sarah Mejia Guerrero. Dr. V. Nin. Dr. Amandeep Singh Sal. Dr. Cynthia Salmasi. Dr. Carl Samay. Dr. Kevan Sepasi. Dr. Maureen Shabila. Dr. Myrna Shabila. Dr. Nandita Shenton. Dr. Michael Lee Tran. Dr. Robert Tran. Dr. Christy Ku Trin. Dr. Kyle Chinu Wang. Dr. Na Wu. Dr. Christian Zong. Dr. Randy Zong. Dr. Jessica Zafra.
Congratulations to all of our candidates for receiving your CHSU College of Pharmacy doctoral hood. Now, it is my honor to initiate the presentation of the candidates. Class of 22, Doctor of Pharmacy candidates, please stand. Madam President, on behalf of the recommendations of the faculty of the College of Pharmacy, it is my distinct pleasure to present these candidates who are duly approved to receive the Doctor of Pharmacy degree for which they are entitled.
By virtue of authorities vested in me by the Board of Trustees of California Health Sciences University, I do now confer upon you the Doctor of Pharmacy degree, to which you are entitled to all the rights, privileges, and obligations thereunto pertain. Congratulations. Please move your tassels from your right to your left. Doctors, please be seated.
Congratulations to my fellow pharmacists and now colleagues. It is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Alan Kashishian Namagerdi, Assistant Professor of Clinical Sciences and CHSU Class of 2018 alumnus, to lead the graduates in reading the Oath of a Pharmacist.
Thank you, Dr. Okamoto. Congratulations to these new PharmDs that have joined our noble profession of the pharmacy. As President Don said, you are not entitled to the all rights, privilege, and obligation that pertain to the Doctor of the Pharmacy degree. The Oath of the Pharmacist adopted by the American Pharmacist Associations is distinct reminder of these rights, privileges, and obligations. It's my honor to lead our new graduates in reciting the Oath of the Pharmacist. Doctors, please stand and then turn to the page 10 on your program. Please join me in reciting the Oath of the Pharmacist. Also, the pharmacist on the stage, you can stand and then join us. Ready? I promise to devote myself to a lifetime of service to others through the profession of pharmacy. In fulfilling this vow, I will consider the welfare of humanity and relief of suffering my primary concerns. I will promote inclusion, embrace diversity, and advocate for justice to advance health equity. I will apply my knowledge, experience, and skills to the best of my ability to assure optimal outcomes for all patients. I will respect and protect all personal and health information entrusted to me. I will accept the responsibility to improve my professional knowledge, expertise, and self-awareness. I will hold myself and my colleagues to the highest principle of our profession's moral, ethical, and legal conduct. I will embrace and advocate changes that improve patient care. I will utilize my knowledge, skills, experiences, and values to prepare the next generation of pharmacists. I take these vows voluntarily with the full realizations of the responsibility with which I am entrusted by the public. You may be seated. Thank you and congratulations again to my new colleagues.
Thank you, Dr. Kashishian. One of our CHSU traditions is to have each cohort of students write their own class pledge of professionalism during their first year. The class pledge is mounted outside of their classroom and signed by all students as a constant reminder. This practice reinforces our culture of shared accountability. And when students have a hand in creating their pledge, we feel that they are more apt to abide by it. So now it is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Maroj Michael Korojian, Class of 2022 President, Pledge of Professionalism. Dr. Korojian was also nominated by his peers to provide a graduate reflection, which he will share after the pledge.
Thank you, Dr. Okamoto. Good morning. I'm honored to lead my fellow pharmacists in reading an excerpt of our Class of 2022 Pledge of Professionalism. Colleagues, would you please turn to page 11 in your program and stand. Ready, begin. As a student of pharmacy, I believe there is a need to build and reinforce a professional identity founded on integrity, ethical behavior, and honor. This development, a vital process in my education, will help ensure that I am true to the professional relationships that I established between myself and society as I become a member of the pharmacy community. Integrity will be an essential part of my everyday life, and I will pursue all academic and professional endeavors with honesty and commitment to service. Thank you. You may now be seated. Now, I'd like to share my graduate reflection for our class of 2022. Fellow graduates, I'd like to congratulate all of you on a job well done and to take a brief moment to soak in this distinguished achievement that we have all accomplished. It is such a pleasure to share the intense emotions filling this auditorium as we, who are graduating, close this chapter of our life story and begin a new one. From the first day of orientation to the last day of our APU rotations, we have acquired an everlasting memory, and I stand here before you, reflecting on 4 years of legacy we've all made together while at CHSU. I can remember the expressions of anxiety, fear, and nervousness we all had while sitting with our newly appointed teams during orientation week and not comprehending what the future entailed before venturing on our journey of becoming healthcare professionals. As time flew by, our confidence expanded as it allowed us to tackle the challenges presented to us week by week and semester after semester. We overcame contesting topics such as infectious disease, pharmacokinetics, and biostatistics in a short amount of time. We faced numerous obstacles in forms of IRATs, applications, exams, OSCEs, and our clinical rotations, and later grinned and welcomed for more. While our perseverance resumed each day on campus, we cannot forget our determination and hard work outside the classroom. By participating in student organizations such as CPHA, APHA, SNAFA, CSHP, many of us were able to volunteer our time and contribute back to our local community, from holding informational health fairs at farmers markets, providing blood pressure or glucose readings at fundraiser events, to finally playing the essential function in furnishing vaccines while combating the pandemic, truly portrays our commitment and pledge to helping others in need. To our faculty and staff at CHSU, on behalf of the graduating class, we would like to thank you for the numerous support you have given us day in and day out. The dedication you have provided us will not go neglected, and the wisdom and knowledge given to us will allow us to begin the next stage of our journey. Armed with the skills and insight gained in the classroom, we will commit to aiding our communities no matter where we venture off. Now to my fellow graduates, who I can tell are enthusiastic about tackling this next phase, while you celebrate the past academic accomplishments and activities today with your friends and family, I ask of you to resume your pursuit for knowledge and to find unique ways to contribute to our societies. So go out and take risks. Set goals, as I challenge you all to take the same enthusiasm you had these past 4 years and continue to acquire anything you seek to achieve. Although many of our paths may lead us to different places, I also implore you to never forget about the relationships you have created. For true friendship is a treasure and cannot be placed. In closing, I would ask the graduates to stand up once more and join me in a round of applause for our family members, friends, faculty and staff, and mentors, and anyone else who helped them reach this achievement and landmark. So please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2022. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kerosian. All the graduates, you may be seated. So in closing, today's a special day for our graduates, our university, and our community. Graduates, you entered this hall today as students, and you depart as our fifth cohort of Doctor of Pharmacy graduates. On behalf of the trustees, administration, faculty, staff, preceptors, current students, and alumni at CHSU, we are beyond proud of you and wish you continued success, prosperity, and good health. I wanted to add a side note to this session as we close, and that is that these students have done far more than most students have done. They have survived their rigor in their academic courses, but they also had to fight with a pandemic that this world has not yet seen. And it has been a very, very difficult time for them and for many of you. And for that, you cannot imagine how proud I am of all of you to be standing here today. Invited guests, we kindly ask that you please remain at your seats until the trustees, faculty, and graduate processional has recessed from the building. Please keep clear the aisles until the processional process is complete. On behalf of the trustees, administration, faculty, and staff, I would like to thank you for joining us here today, including those that joined us virtually, for our CHSU College of Pharmacy Class of 2022 graduation. Congratulations to you all.